It's football season in Montana, and that means it's hunting season too. Keep your taste buds watering whether you're bow hunting or tailgating by staying stocked up on Alpine Touch. The traditional seasoning is perfect for any and all meat. The barbecue sauce, perfect for your tailgate. And the sunflower seeds, amazing, are ideal for hunting camp or your seat at the football stadium. Available at retail locations around the state or at alpinetouch.com. Alpine Touch, Montana's special spice.
Good?
Yep.
All right, obviously, Stein coming back to Missoula. How's it feel to come in here and get a win?
It's awesome. You know, anytime you can win, it's great. It takes a lot of hard work to get them. It takes even more to win on the road, I think. And then particularly in this place, the history of this rivalry has been way lopsided in Idaho's favor, particularly in this venue. So we've kind of got that ship righted. It's good to see our guys with the Little Brown Stein. They carried around like it's a Super Bowl trophy. It's awesome.
We've obviously talked about getting the offense going, and they seemed more in rhythm, and things were clicking on that side of the ball. What did you see, and how would you assess that performance?
I thought it was good. I would give credit to, you know, those players on that side of the ball and the coaches. They put a good plan together. They went out and executed better than they have in quite some time. I'm not sure when the last time we played better than that on offense. So it was a good effort.
You remember the last time you had two true freshmen at running back, and you know, just talk about their performance.
Well, we've got a freshman snapping the ball to freshmen who are handing it and throwing it and pitching it to freshmen. So never before in that regard. Two true freshmen at running back, I mean, that's never be the answer, Kyle.
You touched on just Junior's performance this so far this season on the Monday press conference. You know, after he has a career day, we found out it's his birthday today as well. Just your thought on how he stepped up, and, you know, Coulter as well, kind of in that backup role for some minutes for him.
Hey, those guys did a good job. You know, it's a physical position, and it's a physical game for true freshmen to be in there. They've got a lot of contact, and I'm proud of them for owning up to it and performing well.
But you can't be too physical when you're hitting the quarterback.
Yeah, apparently.
A win like this, big confidence going into Southern Utah next week. Just talk about the confidence of getting this win.
So, yeah, Darren, I don't know. I mean, I think we're a confident football team. I don't think none of that's changed. I suppose if you lose a game, it's human nature. You say that maybe question yourself. But that's beyond what human nature says. I think we've got a confident team. They showed it tonight.
On the defensive side of the ball, this is the fifth straight game that Justin has picked off the opposing quarterback. I'm wondering, just, you know, from the secondary's play, how have you seen them kind of progress and get more comfortable going into this country?
So say that one more time for me.
This is the fifth consecutive game that Justin Ford has picked off the opposing quarterback. Just how do you feel like they've started to gel and become, you know, part of the strength of your defense?
Yeah. Well, it's hot and cold, you know, and being an old secondary coach, I've got some understanding of that. I mean, you're as good as your last play out there, and then you give up a play, you gotta play your next one. Justin has done a good job the last few weeks, and I don't think he's even scratched the surface of what he can do.
What gave you guys the confidence on offense to take as many deep shots down the field passing as you did?
I don't know. I mean, I said that we are confident.
Did Chris look more comfortable at quarterback to you today? Do you think that just those repetitions are kind of helping him out there?
I think comfortable consistently through the game rather than in spots would be my assessment. Just watching it.
And that's just game reps, you think?
I don't know what it is, but it was comfortable tonight.
Seemed a lot more
maybe active. It was, you know, maybe it was the plan. I don't know. We changed the plan. We had some good stuff for him. I think he was going into the game. I think he was really comfortable with the plan. That might have helped.
You mentioned the game plan. It seemed like you started off a lot of short passes, just to kind of get him going and get the offense moving. Was that something that maybe you focused on?
Yeah. I mean, all quarterbacks are different. Some guys need a quick start to play well. Some don't. You know, he's so new and he's a freshman. We don't have any idea what he needs. But that was good to get some completions early and get going. Even though we had to punt on the first drive, felt kind of good about it where it was headed.
Is this where you think a quarterback making his third career start should be 3 games in?
Well, I haven't watched the film yet, so I don't know where he is. I'll have to watch it.
And then when Governor got ejected, I know you're not going to comment on that.
That was just a penalty. I don't think there was an ejection.
It wasn't targeted?
I don't think so. Maybe just roughing back. Maybe I'm wrong.
I thought they called targeting, but said they couldn't review it.
No, it's not targeting because they have to confirm it on the replay. All right, thanks, guys.
At Blackfoot Communications, our mission is to connect people, businesses, and communities to their networks in Montana and beyond. Through Blackfoot sponsorships, local ambassadors, and public programs, we support initiatives such as the Emergency Broadband Benefit, fiber deployments, and community events. For information on our commitment to improving our communities with fast, reliable, and secure internet access, go to blackfootcommunications.com/news.
How's it feel just to come here and get a win?
There's no better feeling. I mean, winning's a hard thing to do, and that was a really good Idaho team. They put their best foot forward, and it feels great to get back in the win category.
How did it feel? You obviously gave up the opening drive touchdown, but then you guys really settled in. I imagine you guys kind of were feeling like you were kind of dictating the tempo and in control on your end.
Yeah. Obviously, there was some stuff that we did wrong on that first possession. But like you said, we figured it out on the sideline. We got that stuff fixed, and then you saw the rest, and we dictated the rest of the game. Biggest thing was first downs, I think. Not letting them get, 5-6 yards on first down. And then we had third and longs to bring some pressure and stuff like that. So.
To see the offense have some sustained drives, make some plays, I mean, does that give you guys a little bit more juice on the sidelines, knowing that they're doing their thing?
Yeah, I mean, those guys, they're working their tails off, do whatever they can to put the ball in the end zone. And if you just watch our sideline, watch us on the bench when they score, we're going crazy. When they're putting those drives together, it feels amazing. And I know that those guys are working their tails off to do what they're doing. So that feels really good. And it's got to feel really good for them.
Football is a game of momentum. Just talk about once you guys get rolling, just how much confidence it builds for you guys.
Oh, yeah. I mean, if you're an outsider looking into this game, I mean, you could probably feel the juice in the stadium that was going for us. It's a huge thing. It's a huge thing to get momentum and just feel that going into the game and once we get playing. So, yeah.
Your boys are busting your chops. Just talk about the camaraderie you guys have on that line.
Oh, yeah. I mean, there's some goofballs out there, me being one of them, but we all love each other. I mean, we battle every day for each other. We know each other personally, and we know how to get after each other, too, just have a little fun. And it's always obviously more fun after you get a win. So I love every single guy on this team and on this defense especially.
Pat, this defense has dealt with some injuries too, especially on the D-line, some guys you having to rotate in, some younger guys having to step up, to see them kind of pay off a little bit, kind of just weather that storm a little bit to have a performance like tonight. What does that say about this defense and the resilience of it?
You just said it. I mean, it shows the resilience of the guys on our team, the no quit factor in everyone, and the standard that we set once you step foot on the field for the Montana Grizzlies. I think everyone embraces that, and you can truly see it, especially with some of the younger guys stepping up and performing and doing what they're taught to do, and they really embrace that role.
When you come into like a second half, it is 20-7, but Idaho, they had some success in the first half. What's kind of the message in the second half for this defense? I know you guys keep coming out hot and keep that momentum.
Yeah, I mean, in that first half, we honestly didn't have too many plays, so it didn't feel like a complete first half. We wanted to come back out here and really dominate the second half. The key word was dominate, and I think that we really did that. So
you guys were rotating a lot of guys at all three levels. How much of that was kind of the game plan going in and maybe trying to keep guys fresh throughout the game?
Yeah, I mean, that was a big factor. There's been some games where a lot of guys are playing a lot of snaps. We like to keep the legs fresh, and you see guys making more plays because of that. And like we said earlier, guys are stepping up and making those big plays for the white and maroon.
What point in the game did you feel like you guys had it going on defense and you just felt they couldn't do anything?
Yeah, so that first drive, you know, they kind of put it on us a little bit, just a couple little things here and there. But really in that second possession, I'm not quite sure. I think we got a three and out. But after that, I felt like our guys saw what we could really do to their offense, and then it kind of showed throughout the rest of the game.
Justin Ford, fifth game in a row with an interception.
Yeah.
That's pretty, you don't see that too often. So mm-hmm. What's it like to be playing on the field with him? Just yeah. What does he have for you?
Justin, he's a really hard worker. He likes to be perfect in his craft. And you see that on the field. He brings the juice, he brings the energy every day. And you can see it on the field. And like you said, five in a row and five games. It's like unheard of. It's like Trevon Diggs in the NFL. He's doing the same thing. So, you know, it's...
With one more thing, Pat, just, you know, you kind of, a couple of years ago, you kind of had to step up as a young guy. You know, on the offense, you get a couple of true freshman running backs who are kind of stepping up from that as well. And from a defensive perspective, you know, seeing those guys kind of step up in their first minutes, what does that mean, what Junior and Coulter have been able to do with that position?
Well, first of all, it's Junior's birthday, so that was a heck of a performance that he did. But like you said, those young guys, they're putting in the same work that everyone else is, especially them knowing that they could get a chance to play. So... It brightens up everyone's mood, and it brings the juice to the whole team when those guys are popping off runs and starting to perform to the level that we know they can. So it's pretty special to see that. And everyone's really proud and happy for those guys.
We've been kind of talking about trying to get that explosive play with the offense for the last couple of weeks. You guys were able to bust out a few of them there. How did it feel to kind of get the ball down the field and make some big plays today?
It felt great to get the ball moving again on the outside, and receivers making plays deep down the field. So it's been good. Moving the ball offensively with the run game as well has been good.
Yeah, how did it feel to kind of just overall just get into, it seems like these were just in a rhythm. Chris was feeling, you know, more confident and things were clicking on offense.
Yeah, I think we just got into a tempo, and once we got into a little bit of a tempo, it slowed them down a little bit and we got into a rhythm. So things just started clicking from there.
Like anything in life, it's all about reps. This is your third game with them. It seemed like you guys really took off. Just talk about your chemistry against that.
I think Chris just got a lot more confident early on in the game, throwing some quick passes and completing them. And then from there, it just the deep ball opened up for us, and we were able to make some deep plays.
It's been a pretty deep ball. How nice is it knowing that you've been open, the ball's coming in?
Yeah, Chris has quite the arm. He can throw it far, so as long as we make the move off the line and get open, he can get it there. So,
Mitch, just to kind of get a win in this one after last week's kind of result, you know, just how does it feel, you know, at the end of this game to, you know, see some of those things come to fruition and come away with a 20-point victory? Like, how does that just feel overall?
Oh, it feels great. I mean, winning's really hard, and we've learned that through this season. So it feels great to get another win under us and move on to next week. So.
You were a guy kind of in 2019 who your name got called a little bit because some injuries ahead of you, and you got to see some more plays on offense. Kind of seeing that at running back right now with Coulter and Junior. Just talk about what they've done for this team. You know, stepping in as two true freshmen and a pretty depleted, you know, spot right there.
Yeah, those guys are doing a great job for us. We're a little low on our running backs right now, but they're doing a great job stepping up, making plays for us, and
going into this one, I mean, Idaho has a good front seven. They've given up a bunch of pass plays. How much did you guys know, like, hey, if we win our jobs as wide receivers, we're going to have a good day?
I think that was kind of the game plan going in, that we could attack the ball downfield more. And once we got our run game going up as well, our pass opened up quite a bit too. So, yeah. I think this week we just brought a bunch of energy each and every day to practice, and we carried that over into the game. So we saw that transition into the game this week.
Jacob, that's just awesome, man. Jacob, good stuff, man.
Thanks, Mitch.
At Blackfoot Communications, our mission is to connect people, businesses, and communities to their networks in Montana and beyond. Through Blackfoot sponsorships, local ambassadors, and public programs, we support initiatives such as the Emergency Broadband Benefit, fiber deployments, and community events. For information on our commitment to improving our communities with fast, reliable, and secure internet access, go to blackfootcommunications.com/news.
You guys get a couple, you know, three and outs on defense to kind of start the game. I guess what was kind of the difference and just the mindset going into this one after, you know, such a tough game last week?
Coming after that loss, you know, we was just trying to win. Honestly, as far as the defense, we had a lot of stuff to work on, a lot of hiccups from last game. So we was just, you know, trying to do as much as we can possible to put our offense in the best position to help us win the game.
You know, obviously they have a tough defense too. So you guys end up being on the field a lot. I mean, I guess what is that kind of like towards the end of the game is, you know, both teams had a ton of punts, but you guys have to kind of keep going back out there.
Yeah, I mean, it's not something we're not ready for as far as defense. You know, it's not something that hasn't happened before. So we just try to attack it with the best mindset possible. You know, just keep on going out there, keep fighting, keep trying to win.
What's kind of your overall assessment of you guys today on the defensive side?
On the defensive side, I say overall assessment is, you know, we had good fight, great fight, but at the end of the day, we ain't win. So it's like we got to go back to the chalkboard. We got to definitely, you know, reroute and think of a new plan to get the dub.
What are you guys kind of thinking on that last drive? You know, they're trying to go for a score again in that final minute there. What are you guys kind of thinking out there?
Not let them score. You feel me? Like, it's as simple as that. Just not let them score. It was already being silly, so.
You've been in a couple of these rivalry games against Montana now. Anything different about these games or about, you know, this year's edition?
This year's edition, I would say because it's my senior year, I feel like it, you know, had a little more weight on it going into this season. I know a couple of the guys on the team, we just want to win, you know, like playing Montana, like it's a rivalry that we kind of got into. We just by being at this school, kind of feeding into that same energy. So like, we just want to beat them at the end of the day.
Did Montana show you anything different that, you know, maybe wasn't on tape, especially with that quarterback who's the new guy? He's only played for a couple weeks.
No, they didn't show us anything different. They came up and, you know, they did everything that we was practicing and they executed. They played a hard-fought game. We played a hard-fought game and the outcome is what it was.
Now, you guys kind of play maybe your two toughest conference opponents in back-to-back weeks now. What's your guys' kind of just mindset now going into this next one as you guys are, you know, going to try to bounce back here?
Finish, you know, it don't stop. Like, we might lose, you know, but it's at the end of the day, like you said, we got another week, we got more games to keep on coming. So we just got to attack Sunday and just keep that mindset. You know, the season's not over yet, so we got to just keep on going, keep on working hard, keep fighting, and just keep on trying to win each game.
What did Coach Petrino say to you guys in the locker room right after that one?
The same thing, you know, the same thing I basically just said, just keep on fighting and hold your heads up and let's go into next week and, you know, go get the dub.
All right, good guys.
Gevani, what was, I guess what you kind of see on that last drive of the game, kind of getting your first touchdown pass as a Vandal out there?
First off, it was a great experience. Just to experience that with this team for that to be my first touchdown, it just felt good with that group of guys out there. And then late in the game too, how we just kept fighting, it felt good.
Yeah, I mean, 2 weeks ago, did you think you were even gonna be, you know, playing it all this season? I mean, what's kind of your mindset been like through this?
So at first, I kind of just thought I would be like third string and just step in if anything happens. And then I got told that I was gonna be moved up. And honestly, I've just been in the playbook, and I've just been in the just with the coaches meeting, and just I've just been trying to get right with all of my teammates and just build chemistry. And yeah, that's all.
As it looked like, as that game went on, you were seeing more things. You were releasing the balls more on target, with more confidence. It looked like you were picking up those blitzes, too.
Yes, sir.
Can you kind of take us through the course of that game when you started feeling better about being out there?
So the beginning of the game, they showed some of these what are they, like, blitzes that that we went over, and so we studied for them, and we had like checks and stuff. And so to start off, I just had to get my feet wet basically, and then I started to like see them move and stuff like that. And as the game on, I just started to get more comfortable.
What's it like going against a defense like that that blitzes so much, you know, almost every play?
It's different, but it's still football at the end of the day. We just got to make plays and just do the right checks.
And how are you kind of feeling physically? Obviously, you know, taking some hits out there with scrambling and whatnot, and yeah.
Honestly, I feel fine. I feel fine. Honestly, I don't feel too beat up. We just got to get back to work on to next week. Honestly.
What's it like for you? And you had a long run of snaps there at the end of the game, but what's it like for you going in and out and trading off with Zach?
Honestly, whatever the team needs, that's what I'm going to do. So if that's the way that it has to be, then I'm fine with it. I'm just there to play.
All right,
guys. Anybody? Coach, you know, your offense drives down that field on that first drive, all those run plays, gets in the end zone, and then kind of Miami's defense kind of kicks in after that. I guess what you see on that drive, what kind of changed the rest of the game?
I think our guys came out, and I think it was a couple different things that maybe they hadn't seen, and then they kind of just went to, when Zach was in there, they went to cover zero, and then we just kind of put everybody down around the line, and then when that's the case, you got to break tackles. You got to block really well, and you got to break tackles, and they made some adjustments, and there was a couple times that it was really close to still having good plays, and we hurt ourselves, you know, a couple times with some bad snaps again. And, we didn't move the ball quite as well. I was very impressed with the young quarterback, though. Thought he fought his tail off. And he's going to be a great player. He's going to end up being a great player here someday. He's super tough. He has the it factor. He's tough. He can run. He can spin it. It's just, he's a true freshman. And his first two times he had to play were against Eastern Montana. That's a little tough, you know, but sometimes he's still learning things. He's still getting better. But if there is something for the Vandal family and fans and everyone else to be excited about, is Gevani. Because there's a lot of good things that he's done.
Does it look like you're going to be going with those two, Borish and McCoy, the rest of the way? Or?
You know what? I'm not 100% sure. It for sure was that way today. You know what, it'll probably happen is either we are for sure or somebody will be back next week.
Next week.
I think that'll be the case probably. I think probably someone will be back next week, and if they're not next week, then that'll probably be the case for the rest of the year.
And if it is the case the rest of the year, are they learning quickly enough to be able to help you win games before the season is over?
Yeah, I think so. We just got to, you know, and it's not just them. It's everybody around them. There was two very, you know, tough opponents, back-to-back. I do think they're improving, and they've taken big steps. And, yeah, we got to believe they can. And we got to get ready to win the game next week against NAU.
Is that a bit of a confidence booster for that true freshman to have that touchdown drive kind of towards the end of the game there?
Yeah, come back from the late hit. I mean, that you can't build much more confidence. He got whacked. Came back in after that, made a bunch of great plays. And it was too bad after we recovered the onside, he made three great throws. It was dropped. But he made three throws again, right in a row. Bam, bam, bam. He got hit on a couple of those. So, I think his confidence should be very high after the way he performed.
And as far as your guys' defense, you know, you guys forced them to punt those first two drives. You know, obviously looking a lot better than that UW game.
Yeah.
And then I guess what you kind of see from your defense today?
I thought they fought hard today. You know, I thought our defense made a big improvement today. We needed to move the ball more offensively. I thought the defense actually made a huge improvement today and fought very hard and competed. Couple PIs hurt us, you know, kept some drives alive. But I thought they fought really hard. And we just got to keep, that's all we can do, keep fighting. There's nothing else we can do but just keep fighting and get back to work this week and keep improving and find a way to beat NAU next week.
Is that some kind of rivalry game stuff kind of coming out at the end? You know, you guys are going for the onside, and then they, when they get the ball back, like, they're going straight for the end zone with less than a minute left there.
Yeah, I don't know. We go for the onside because got to try to score again and get the young quarterback more reps. So what they do at the end, that's up to them. They can do whatever they want. That's why it's football. They got the ball, they try to score. We don't have the ball, we try to stop them. I mean, that's, I don't have any problem with that at all. That's what people do. You got the ball, you try to score. And they put in a younger quarterback trying to get him reps. So I had no problem with that.
Did you and Bobby say anything to each other after the game when you had the handshake?
Yeah, good game. See, so, yeah. Like, we've known each other forever. I didn't have a problem with it, honestly. I mean, that's you play to win. You play to get people reps. No problem with getting my butt kicked, but I didn't have a problem with that.
What did you think of Montana's defense? I mean, they came in with a good reputation, and they run that 3-3-5, and they bring a lot of pressure from unique angles. What are the challenges of playing against that defense?
Yeah, they do a good job. They play super hard. I think that's the biggest thing. Their kids, they play hard. They play hard down after down. They run. They tackle well. So they do a lot of good things.
Did you notice anything with the fans out there that was a little different tonight?
What was that?
I know there was one guy that they had a couple police officers talk to him. Do you notice anything about that?
I'm trying to coach the game. I don't usually notice anything with the fans, actually.
So what do you tell the guys tomorrow and the rest of the week about going forward with this season?
That it's life, man. You got two choices. Keep fighting, keep working as hard as you can to get better, or quit. And we're not going to quit. We're going to keep fighting. We're going to keep working as hard as we can to improve. So, yeah, that's part of life. That's what you do in life. And that's really what sports are all about, is teaching you how to keep fighting and keep moving forward. And I thought they came out and practiced hard this last week, and we made improvements. We played better this week than we did last week. Now we got to make big improvements so we play even better next week and get a win.
Is that similar to what you told them after the game, or what did you say to them after the game?
Very similar.
Yeah.
I guess.